Okay, in this video we're going to talk about electrophilic aromatic substitution. Okay, this is also known as EAS. So we abbreviate electrophilic aromatic substitution as EAS. And in this reaction, what we're going to do is generate some E plus or EA. So in this video, we're just going to talk about the general mechanism of how this process works. We're not going to get into specifics yet on what this E plus is or the EA is. For each reaction, when we go through this, we will generate E plus or EA first. But I just want to talk about the mechanism after we generate that species. Okay, so what we see that happens in this reaction is we start with a benzene ring, and then we add some reagents, which generates E+. Again, this is just some generic species, or EA. And we are substituting a hydrogen in this position with this generic E. So this is electrophilic aromatic substitution. Electrophilic because our E+, or EA, has a positive charge or a partial positive charge. We're substituting our aromatic ring, replacing an H with now RE. Okay, so what we're going to do in the mechanism, we can see the reaction. Again, we replace the H with the E. So let's just draw our mechanism. So our first step is we're going to take one of the double bonds from our benzene ring and attack this E+. So again, a generic E+. Or what we could do is, instead of attacking the E+, or you could attack the E, which breaks the EA bond. So it depends on the species you generate whether you attack E+ or EA. When we talk about specific examples, we will go through both of those. So let's see what we form after we do that step. So we're going to have our benzene ring. And now we originally had an H here. We now have a new bond to our E, whatever that group is. The two alkenes we had before are still here. And now we've broken one of the alkenes, and we now have a carbocation on this carbon here. So this compound that we formed is no longer aromatic, and it is much higher in energy than our benzene ring, because this compound is no longer aromatic, because that is an sp3 hybridized carbon. So now that we've formed this intermediate, why this reaction does proceed is because we can form many resonance structures. So let's draw these resonance structures out. So what I'm going to do now is use kind of an orange color to show the different resonance structures I can draw. So if I move these two electrons over here, I can generate a new resonance structure. So let's draw that resonance structure now. We still have our H bond, carbon to H. We still have our new bond to E. Now we have a double bond here. The other double bond is still on the opposite side, and our carbocation has now moved to the bottom. Okay, we can do this one more time. We can draw another resonance structure. And again, I'm going to use orange to show what happens. This double bond can now move here. The consequence of that is the resonance structure we're drawing now. We still have a bond to H and a bond to E. Our double bond on the right is still there. And now our double bond has shifted over, and the consequence of that is we have the carbocation on the species on the left. Okay, so what we've basically done here is we did our first step in the mechanism. Okay, we attacked our E, generating this carbocation, which is stabilized by resonance. So we can move the double bond here to draw that resonance structure, move the double bond here to draw that resonance structure. So these resonance structures are important. They show that even though this molecule is not aromatic and higher in energy, it is stabilized by resonance, which is why this reaction does proceed. So now let's continue on with the actual mechanism. Okay, so again, whether we attack our E plus or attack our EA, we do have something that we can use to do our next step, which is a deprotonation. So I'll just use that A and draw in a lone pair here, and that has a minus sign. So drawing our mechanism, this lone pair can now form a new bond from A to H, and the electrons from the carbon-hydrogen bond now reform our double bond. Okay, the consequence of that is we now have formed our product. Okay, so to recap the steps of the mechanism, first we break up the aromaticity. One of the double bonds attacks the E plus or the EA. We form this intermediate here. To complete the mechanism, A minus, some species, acts as a base to take the H. The carbon-hydrogen bond breaks, reforming my aromatic ring, and now I have substituted that H that was originally here with our E. So overall, this is a two-step mechanism from here to here and there to there. And the other key thing to note is that we do have resonance structures with our first intermediate, which is why the reaction proceeds. So this is the general mechanism for electrophilic aromatic substitution, or EAS, and this is the mechanism we're going to see over and over when we're doing EAS reactions. What we will change, or what we'll have to do first, is figure out how we generate E plus, or our EA species, which then initiates the reaction. Okay, so let's just look at a problem for you to work on. So what I'd like you to do here is draw the product form when benzene reacts with a tertiary carbocation. So the carbocation is on this carbon in the center. Notice there's four carbons here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to do the exact same EAS reaction. We don't have to worry about how this carbocation is generated. We'll talk about that later. But I want you to draw the product that you get here and draw the mechanism and all of the resonance structures to complete this reaction. So draw the product of the EAS reaction and the mechanism to complete it.